Hi, we're here with Eminem.
May I have your attention, please?
How do you feel about the critics that have been criticizing you?
I think they're all messed up, and no matter what they're saying, gonna change. And it seems every time critics slams me, or what else sues me, I just sell more records.
Okay. So your new song, The Way I Am, is that how you really feel?
Yeah, it's how I totally feel. If you don't like my music, you don't gotta listen to it.
I see. So why do you hate pop music so much?
I think sissy music. They all sound the same. Same lyrics, basically.
Besides all the lawsuits and stuff, how do you really feel?
I guess I'm good.
That's good to hear. Do you think you're going to win any awards tonight?
I don't go anywhere expecting to win anything, because if you don't, then you're disappointed.
I see. So what are you doing for your performance tonight?
I can't tell you that. It's just going to be wild.
Well, the show's going to get started soon, so we got to go to talk to you after the show.
All right.
We're back here with Eminem.
Hey, Kurt.
Were you surprised with all the awards you got?
Yeah, 3 is pretty many.
So how many guys that came out to you on stage?
I think it was like 200 or something.
So what are you doing after you leave? Any plans?
I think I'm gonna hit a few parties.
Well, that's about all the time we have. It's been nice.
Hey.
As cuddly as a cactus, you're as charming as a new Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster.
Good morning and welcome to UN77. I am your host, Dan Chile, and this is Nancy Abdelrahim. And now for your feature story with Nancy.
Thank you, Dan. A madman named Jeffrey Dahmer, a notorious serial killer who was murdered by his prison inmate, still lives on in Milwaukee County. 10 years ago, Dahmer would abduct his victims in a busy area, take them to his east side apartment, slaughter them in a brutal manner, and ate their flesh. The majority of these people were African Americans. Now, these new brutal killings, the killer abducts his victims the same way, except the killer ties it to a tree and leaves it headless. No one is yet a suspect, but police are questioning.
Ah! Jeffrey Dahmer tried to eat me! Please help me. Invite out here. But I have to come right now. Where did he go?
Hello. Okay. A curfew has been advised for all of Milwaukee County. Now more local news with Crystal Larson.
Late one night at St. Francis Hospital in Milwaukee. He was taken along with the driver, 19-year-old Jeffrey Brown, who was in satisfactory condition early Tuesday morning. The scene of the accident happened right over there on the corner of Coots and Hall Ave. Life lost, and students who knew John were extremely sad. The students were very respectful and very caring and grieved with the family. Everyone knows what that loss is.
Family and friends, we give you our sympathy here at UN77. This is Crystal Larson reporting to you live with UN77. Now back to you, Amber, with weather.
and here's your weather. Today it's going to be sunny, and it's going to be a high of 20 and a low of 7, and here's a 3-day forecast. Then now here's Brandon with sports.
Fucking door.
Tiger Woods and three other sports stars are suing Planet Hollywood, accusing the embattled
restaurant chain of breaching endorsement contracts during its recent bankruptcy proceedings. Representatives of Woods, NFL Hall of Famer Joe Montana, and tennis star Andre Agassi and Monica Sales filed the lawsuit in U.S. District Court in Delaware, where the company filed for Chapter 11 sports named All-Star Cafe Restaurant and paid unspecified damages. The lawsuit Hollywood reached those deals with athletes when it dumped several Star Cafe locations. And now to law.
Commercial.
You're a freak. Go home. Brandon, you don't know what you're doing. You, like, can't read.
In my love.
All over your body.
I'm gonna dress you up in my love.
All over your body. From your head down to your toes.
If you want to be hip, you got to get some new Gap super suspenders.
Boing.
Your pants will stay up and you'll be cool at the same time. At $19.95, everybody will be wearing them.
Breaking news. An earthquake had just taken place in Madison, Wisconsin. No word on damage caused yet, but 3 are already reported dead, and over 300 are found seriously injured. One little boy even died from serious head injuries. This just in, 23 more people are found dead, and 3 people died from heart attacks. Damage as far as 23 million and rising. Its magnitude was 6.1 to 6.3. Stay tuned for more information. And now, news with Dan.
Our international news comes from Down Under in New Zealand. In Christchurch, New Zealand, a 14-year-old girl, a first-time offender, has been locked up in a Christchurch Central Police Station cell for 4 days. The cells are basic, with no natural light and little space. The reason for this is there was no beds in the New Zealand Youth Justice Centers. In the case of the 14-year-old girl, the charges were serious, and the girl had told CYFS that she would run away if she was placed with her mom or in a community care.
If you want to lose weight, buy FabBeGon, the new pill on the market for fast weight loss. Call 1-800-FabBeGon now.
Just watch your mouth, or I'll sit on you.
Oh, yeah, I want it. Send me FabBeGon right away. Oh, cool, it's here. Wow, it worked. I'm so skinny, I can actually see my feet.
This product may cause drowsiness, dizziness, heart or liver failure, and sometimes death. FabBeGon is not approved by the FDA.
But I never used a phone booth, and I never seen my toes. When I'm going to the movies, I take off seven rolls because I'm fat, fat, fat. Shampoo, be fat.
On Wednesday, I'll go and give the speech saying that he is quitting the election and saying his family, life, and the future of our country are more important. Bush also has chosen the first person to be in his cabinet, which is the new Secretary of State, Colin Powell. This is Jared Kusick reporting for Freshmen on the agenda. 77, now back to you, Nancy.
Now back to Crystal Larson with the latest update for Pennies for Peace.
For about 3 weeks, students have been collecting pennies to win a free concert from radio station 103.7 KISS FM. The concert features sensational hit boy band O-Town and new pop singer Vitamin C. The pennies collected are going to an anti-violence school fund. Here's what some students and teachers had to say about it. Well, the time is here to find out your four runners-up and winners of Pennies for Peace. Starting it off in fifth place was Oak Creek High School. Christine Case took fourth. For third place are winners from last year's Christina Aguilera's concert, Franklin. Second place goes to St. Joe's Antioch. And your winners for this year's Pennies for Peace with a total of 652,000 pennies. Congratulations to Oconomowoc. Well, this is Crystal Larson reporting local news to you on UN77. Now back to you.
In Oshkosh, Marcus Henderson, 22, and his 68-year-old grandmother as a shield after forcing her to withdraw money from an ATM machine. In this shootout, the grandmother, Minnie Johnson, got shot twice in her left leg and in her left wrist and right ankle. This is not known who shot the bullets at Johnson. Officer Kenny Knoz was shot in the leg and the shoulder. Johnson was listed in a stable condition Saturday. Now back to Brandon.
A volcano near Mexico City sprouted showers of colorful rock late Monday morning. Okay, those biggest eruptions since returning to life 6 years ago.
Santa Laura.
Now back to you, Laura. Our commercial.
Man, I choose to live my life.
Yo. That was me 5 years ago. I have since grown up. I now have a steady job. Back in the day is when I had the real troubles. I made the terrible decision to join the gang. Fighting was a nightly occurrence. My mom was never home, so I had to join a gang for a new family. I was what I thought happy until my friend was victim of a drive-by. I realized I didn't want my life to end that way or go to prison. I was lucky. I got out with a very little beatdown. Here are some facts about gangs. Some reasons to join the gang are a new family, also to fit in, or protection. Some gang activities involve robbing banks, stealing cars, using drugs, selling drugs, and fighting. And here are some gang symbols. Learn from my mistakes and say no to no to gangs. And remember, hang tough, Milwaukee!
Last night, a 32-year-old female was shot in a local bar parking lot. The female was pronounced dead at the crime. Police believe that this case may be related to a murder case that happened in the same parking lot 2 weeks ago. Please advise people to stay away from this local bar parking lot until things settle down with this case. If you have any information about these cases, please call the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Department. Now to Dan with editorial.
Last week, we asked you to send in by email what you thought of Al Gore and his persistence on the run for the White House. We picked out a couple of lines from a couple of emails. George from Kenosha said, "He really needs to stop this whole thing. The U.S. is going to get annoyed, and if he plans on running again, we the people of the United States will not want to vote for him." Bill from Milwaukee said, "I think he was doing the right thing at first, but now it is getting out of control." And Jan from Racine said, "I think he should pursue it because he deserves to be our next president." And Marge from Greenfield said, "He would have had the votes to win if he had more time, so he deserves to win." These views and opinions do not reflect the views of people here on UN77. And our next story. With Jared.
Agreeing to decide whether the drug can be provided to patients out of medical necessity. The justices said they will hear the Clinton administration's effort to bar the California group from providing the drug to seriously ill patients for pain and nausea relief. 8 other states, in addition to California, have medical marijuana laws in place or approved by voters. Those states include Alaska, Arizona, Hawaii, Maine, Oregon, Washington, Nevada, and Colorado. Marijuana has been effective in relieving nausea from cancer patients, combating weight loss in HIV positive patients. This is Jerry Cusick reporting nationals to you on UN 77. Back to you, Nancy.
Thank you for tuning in to UN 77. I'm Nancy Abzerahim.
And I'm Dan Vachilli. Happy holidays and have a Merry Christmas.
Santa won't be back next Christmas Eve. It sounds strange, I know, it's hard to believe.